This is an introduction to the square root property. All right, so we have our equation, and we're going to look at it and use a little common sense here to figure out what the solutions could be. So it's asking us what squared equals 4. And you probably say 2, which is correct. But there's another number. It could also be negative 2. If you plug in a negative and you square it, it becomes a positive. So we get a 2 or a negative 2. So how about this one? What squared would equal 81? So 9 or negative 9. I think you guys have it. So the short form that we write this as plus or minus 2. Plus or minus 9. It's a way that we can write it shortly. Okay, so what if you have 8? It's not as nice. So what we're doing on each one is basically this. You're putting a square root around each one. And the square root is canceling the square to give us x. And then over here, what's the square root of 81? 9. But see how we're only getting 1? So we always put a little plus or minus in front, which gives us a plus or minus here. So that's what we're going to do here. Square root cancels it, and we get x equals. And you got to put a little plus or minus there, because you could have a positive or a negative. Now you just have to simplify the radical. So we have 8, which is 2 times 2 times 2. We take out our pair, and there we go, plus or minus 2 radical 2. So we get 2 radical 2 or negative 2 radical 2. And that's it. That's all you have to do with square root property. All right, so let's have you try these two right here. If you know the answer, just go straight for it. If you want to use a square root property, do that as well. Hit pause and give them a shot. So those are the answers you should have. So we square rooted both sides to get rid of the square. Gives us x. Make sure you put the plus or minus. So you should have a positive or a negative 12. Also, the way you remember is how many answers are there. There's 2. So make sure you end up with that 2. 2 answers. All right. So I'd like to see this at the end. X equals 12 or x equals negative 12. X equals 6 or x equals negative 6. Okay? All right, now try the little bit trickier ones. Let's do one more together, and then I'll let you try that one. So, we take the square root of each side, put a little plus or minus. So that gives us x equals plus or minus that. So what is the square root of 72? So that's 8 and 9. It's 3 and 3. 2 and 4. 2 and 2. It's 3, 2, 6 radical 2. And that's it. And then we write our full answer, x equals 6 radical 2, or x equals negative 6 radical 2. And that's the better answer. All right, try that one. Hit pause and give it a shot. And there you have it. It's a nice little method, huh? So again, remember to make sure you have 2 answers written.